Against the Texans, and they did with masks. It was 42-23.
Wow.
But our next game is with the Jets. And hopefully we won that game. We won the first one.
You're not.
But it's okay. I'm a fan no matter what.
Yeah. Lawyer. Even if someone shows you repeatedly that they're losers.
That's my real team. I'm a basketball fan.
Okay.
Heat right now are 2-2.
Okay.
They won last night against the Trailblazers.
Nice.
The score was 120-111.
Oh.
And I ended up going to the Heat game and play against the Knicks Wednesday.
Wednesday.
Blowout. Wait, we have a Knicks fan. Someone
do we have any Knicks fans
right in the building?
Yeah.
I got a Knicks fan.
Salty. Real salty over there.
I don't really know. We got lost. If you didn't know, Nick,
you got lost. Sorry.
Next game is tomorrow night.
Okay.
So, because we are talking about sports, let's talk about Rihanna and turn it down.
Okay, you know how to type of way because, you know, Rihanna is, you know, you be talking real extra about her.
I'm upset about it.
When we went to the wax museum in, was it in Cali?
Vegas.
Did we see a Rihanna statue?
We did.
Was that the one that you took a picture? You was extra?
Yeah, and she was bent over her. Bad extra.
Thank you, best friend.
If it wasn't a wax figure, like, I would have to talk to my friend, like, you might have to leave this one.
Thank you.
Mad disrespectful.
That is a hall pass.
She did some stand-up shit.
So, what happened? So, no, I mean, she's turned it down. Of course, you know, about the
Super Bowl.
Calling,
right?
Kaepernick.
So, you know, Colin Kaepernick. Colin K has taken a lot of heat for his stance, right? Standing up for police brutality, violence. You know, unfortunately, a lot of people are missing the message and thinking that it's a fight against America, a fight against the flag, but of course, those who have been following him should know that that's not what it's about. So recently, a lot of people have been, you know, standing up with him. And Rihanna most recently said that, you know, she's not going to participate in the Super Bowl.
That was some boss bitch
Which
shit.
Is big.
That's a lot of dollars.
Shit.
That's not
what
she stands up for. That's
kudos to her. Jay-Z said, I don't need a Super Bowl, you need me. You know what I mean? Taking a stance and standing up with Colin. Also, that actress, what's her name? I want to call her Amy.
Amy Schumer or something. She don't either. You're stupid.
She's not gay.
Amy.
We love Amy. Amy's coming to the barbecue, y'all. We love Amy.
Now, she said that, you know, look, I can't, you know, say that I'm not going to perform at the Super Bowl,
right.
But what I can do is say that I am not going to do a Super Bowl commercial. And I appreciate that she said, look, I know this sounds like very privileged of me, but this is all I got. But I'm going to do what I can do. And it was really great for her to take a stand and stand up and say, look, I'm not going to participate in this. Anything that I can do to support, I'm gonna do it and support it.
Yeah,
so it was great.
Go ahead. What's time for the Becky? What time for Amy?
We can definitely appreciate that.
So we got Rihanna T. What else we got?
I even have to go into her Instagram.
I will say one thing. After watching the video, I think
I got it.
I understand.
Did you guys see?
Like, just follow the video.
Have you guys seen the Spice video?
She shocked a lot of people when she deleted all of her IG posts.
Yeah,
and then had a post of herself basically looking as if her skin was bleached.
Yeah, white chicks. Like a white lady, blonde hair.
The white chicks in the movie.
Yeah, like she had. There was no explanation.
No explanation.
And people are like, okay, because you know Jamaican Sorry, y'all. Caribbeans are known to bleach their skin. Kind of all, you know, y'all do.
So there's a lot of classism that goes on in the Caribbean. A lot of colorism in the Caribbean and in the United States. But as days that Sardatuan Spice, you know, explained what she was doing and why she was doing it. She had a new single that came out called Black Hypocrisy.
Yeah.
And what it talks about is the hypocrisy in the Black community, where a lot of people, a lot of Black people, will think that you're only beautiful if you are light skinned, or which I am beautiful.
No, I'm just saying, I was using you as an example.
Why are you?
But you're not beautiful because you're light skinned. You're beautiful because I love you.
Is this colorism? Is this Black hypocrisy right going on right now?
It might be.
Yes, I am beautiful, and you're Black, and you are beautiful, Queen. So you know, it speaks to her song. Her stance speaks to colorism in the Black community, and why is it that we fight against each other? You know, yes. We would love that racism and bigotry will end. But at the same time, we have our own fight and we have our own struggle within our own community. So if you haven't heard the song, check the song out. I would support it just to support the message and the song. It's a really great message and a really great stance that Spice is taking. She looked a little scary. She was freaking us out at first.
But you know what?
It was a great song.
She made a statement.
Yes.
She got attention.
Yes, she did.
And she did exactly what she needed to do. And I think what stood out for me the most is what she said. She was like, you know what? I'm sorry to tell you, but it's not the Caucasians that were giving me this issue. It was my own people.
Yeah.
You know, and I think as much as we stand up for, you know, Black power and Black Lives Matter, and I'm not saying that those things are not right, but I think we sometimes need to internalize as a community and ask ourselves, okay, well, what am I doing to help my community?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Maybe if we were made more cohesive as a community, it wouldn't be so easy for us to be divided by outsiders. So.
Yeah.
I think it was a great message. Initially, I was like, I want a blood clot, Spice.
Spice, I want it. Spice,
I want it.
I want it.
Spice, I want it. Spice, I want it. I support her, Spice, here. Can you take over? We support you, girl.
Yeah.
We think that it's a great message. And it's the truth. You know, it's you and I, you know, corporate America, some of the issues that I've had. And I shared it with Nancy when I was thrusted in corporate America, a lot of the issues that I had were not with the Caucasian.
I know.
My issues were with my people. It was witch hunt from my fellow Black sisters. So, you know, it's a reality. You know, it's absolutely reality. And I applaud her for taking that stance and being able to speak so openly about that. And, you know, it was a great way. I think she did a great way.
She did. Phenomenal with that. This is a sort of a sad story, but kind of sort of on the same topic of bigotry and racism. Recently in Pittsburgh, there was a shooting at a synagogue.
Oh, yeah.
I'm looking at the Washington Post. A suspect in Pittsburgh synagogue shooting charged with 29 counts and deaths of 11 people. It's just like, what's going on?
This whole week, Pittsburgh would have been hate crimes. And that's just
so
crazy.
So much hate is. And when is it going
to
start?
I'm trying to see. It's like, you know, election time is next week.
Mm-hmm.
It could be all, as me, it's all
It could be a little bit of a distraction. But I think that with that being said, guys, make sure that you are going out there and you are voting. Because it's important. We need to not be.
And have these officials that are in place that are on the same side that you are on when it comes to gun control and violence. Because no matter what side you're on, whether it be, just take a stand, somebody. Yeah. Y'all do something. Just do something. Don't just sit back and get on Instagram and talk about why they got the guns. Why can't I have my guns? Why they got the guns? Why can't I have it? Do something, okay?
Do something.
Vote. Either way, get out there and vote. But the violence, it's insane. It has to stop. So we're just going to end with a little bit of pettiness.
Of course. It wouldn't be the BB corn if we didn't.
John
50.
John 50.
Did you hear about 50 Cent?
Oh my gosh. So y'all know that John Rule and 50 Cent have been beefing for forever. Okay, like, you know, I feel like I grew up in the hip hop era, 90s. I'm an 80s baby. But, you know, it's like I feel like they can beat them
up. You are not an 80s baby.
Yes, I was. So, okay, 1980, don't play yourself, ma'am. I just made it.
So if I fuck up, you know, just roll with the punches. Okay.
We're gonna roll with it. That's what we do. That's what we do.
Roll with it. So, but yeah, so don't go too far because we're actually going to have his chef Kiara Hardy kill us in the kitchen. Not only are we gonna have an opportunity, guys, to speak with her and kind of get some, you know, the holidays are around the corner. So
yeah,
I was able to get some really great questions from some of my my viewers, as well as online, to just kind of ask her, and also to don't speak on the program. I know you and I kind of talked about some of your questions, like your little attempts on trying to, you know, that's even if you're over doing.
Pause. Okay, yes, I am. But we're still trying to determine if it's gonna be at my house or my mom's house. By the way, yes, I'll be doing something. And I'm going to do as many meatless dishes as possible. So, yeah, I
so you might have some questions about that.
Yes.
Okay, all right. So, definitely don't go too far. Babe, we just know you eat. You're the queen, and I cook shit. And everything.
I'm the tester. I don't cook shit.
Yeah.
I'm the test everything.
And you do a great job. Whatever I can do to make sure that I facilitate your ass getting fatter, I will do it, babe.
Wow. And it is.
It is.
I'm sorry, babe. This camera is
Well, thank you guys so much. We're going to go ahead and bid you back goodbye, but again, all right. Before we're gonna get this kitchen killer on. So thank you.
Yes.
Yes. All right. Yes. All right. Thank you.
Bye. All right, guys. I have to admit. So there's two things going on here. One, upgrade your party got me a little bit fucked up. And two, I'm a little bit nervous. I'm only nervous because this guest, I think, is absolutely amazing. The more research that I've done about Kiara, the more things that I've learned about her, the more that I've been exposed to the different clientele that she has. Like, this, she's a fucking boss, y'all. Not only she's a boss, she is good at what she does, and she gives back to her community. So, guys, please, without further ado, I'm using my mic for this one. Join me in welcoming none other than the one and only
Kitchen. And I learned a lot about you that I didn't know, and I think nobody probably would have known unless they had an opportunity like this. So I want to talk a little bit about your background. I want to talk about what got you started. Like, how did that, how do you just wake up one day and say, you know what, I'm going to cook for someone. You know?
Right, right.
What's your story?
So I think I woke up pretty early saying I wanted to cook for people. But doing it professionally was something totally different.
Okay.
So I worked in retail and grocery for a long time,
right,
probably 10 or 12 years, just kind of found my way, and I did it well. I can't say that I didn't. I did it well. I made decent money doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But then, you know, long story short, the last company I was working for went out of business, and I literally found myself at home, you know, watching one of those Art Institute commercials.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, I think I'm going to go to art school. I'm going to go to culinary school. And I was actually in the interview process with another company.
Okay.
And just kind of like figuring out, do I go back and do something I'm not really happy doing, making good money?
Right.
Or do I go do something I love to do? So I ended up going to culinary school. It was like on the cusp of my 30th birthday.
Wow.
And with the culinary school, it started all over. My first culinary job, I was making $10 an hour. And
that's very humbling.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Oh, definitely.
That's very humbling.
But believe it or not, it was the best sleep I had gotten in years.
Really?
Like, you know, I was bringing home probably a fifth or
right.
a sixth of what I had been making. And, you know, I was sleeping good at night. I was happy. I was at peace. And for once, I actually loved going to school. I mean, I had tried the whole college thing prior to going to working in retail and grocery, and it was my thing. I struggled with trying to figure out, do I like school? And
right.
ultimately was like, nah, I don't.
School's not so, very good.
Yeah, but yeah. But then I fell in love with it when I was in culinary school.
Right.
I was in love with cooking.
What part of it did you fall in love with? Because you already had the background. You already had the passion. So what was
all
that
I had?
Yeah,
all I had was the passion. Was just liking to cook. I had cooked at home.
Okay.
But I had never cooked professionally. I'd never cooked for anyone outside of my family or people.
Really?
Yeah, that was it at that point. And so it was just being around other people who had knowledge, being around people who had been cooking in restaurants, being around culinary instructors, and literally just being in professional kitchens, that just kind of was shock and awe for me. And so I wanted to spend a night there. Like, I could not learn enough.
Okay.
I couldn't learn enough. And so it was fun for me, and I loved it. I mean, if it was free, I'd probably still be there. But yeah, so it was fun. It was great. And wow. And every bit of it, really, I mean, outside of probably having to go home and actually do homework.
Right.
But, you know, every bit of it was fun for me. I met really great culinary students who were there with me, who I still interact with. And most importantly, culinary instructors who became mentors and leads for jobs in the future. So it was a great, great experience.
So let me ask you, when you started to go to school,
mm-hmm.
and you all of a sudden you were sparked with all of this excitement, and you were like, wow, this is different. Because, you know, things you went to school before,
right.
This is a completely different experience for you. Sure. As you were going through school, what were some of the things that you said, you know what, this might be my niche. This is going to be how I'm going to stand out. At what point did you notice that? Did you feel that?
Well, culinary school was a lot about fundamentals. Right, it was a lot about how do you cook eggs? How do you
use cook? Wait,
yeah, oh. Yeah. There was a whole we spent like eggs. We took 2 weeks talking about eggs.
On eggs,
poaching eggs, scrambling eggs, frying eggs, egg omelets. You because those are fundamentals.
Okay,
you know, and if you work in high end restaurants, if you can't make a French omelet, you're done.
You're right.
So it's very, very important. So we did a lot of that stuff. Knife skills, cleanliness, all those things.
Okay.
So at the beginning, you know, it's just about, are you passionate about doing it the right way?
Got it.
And for me, it was sure, because I knew that I needed those fundamentals in order for me to kind of incorporate the things that I felt I could do.
Right.
And so, you know, in the future, it was just about how do I incorporate the fundamentals into what's my thing. And it took a while to figure out what my thing was.
Okay.
But ultimately, it was just sophisticated comfort food. So
is that your thing?
Yeah, so that's my thing.
Sophisticated comfort food.
That's my thing.
Yeah. That's her thing.
That's my thing.
That's your thing. Yeah. Wow, okay. So you realized that you found your niche, okay, and you were taking advantage of the things that you were learning there, all right? So now you're there, you're learning. At what point did you realize or did you have an idea of what your journey was going to be? Did you know that you would be kitchen killer or were you just kind of going through the process? What was that like for you? What was your epiphany? What was like, you know what? I think I'm going to do this.
Well, what I knew was that I did not want to work for anybody.
Hello. Say it again. So,
yeah, I mean, I knew that at some point I was going to have to transition into the culinary industry and I would have to do it and work under people. But having worked so long in retail and being miserable, retail, grocery, and just not being happy, you know, I knew that once I figured it out, that the end goal was not to work for other people.
Right.
So my kind of, I thought my advantage was in culinary school is because I had so much background in multi-unit management and, you know, profit loss and those things. So when it came time to taking those culinary classes that had to do with managing numbers and building menus and cost management and that kind of stuff, I was like above, you know, had shoulders above everyone.
Can I stop you for a second? Sure. So you kind of mentioned something that I think when a lot of people think of chefs, they don't think about, which is the business side. So you kind of said some things there. Cost, profit, loss.
Yeah.
So is that something that Kitchen Killer also offers or is that just something that you...
Yeah, definitely. So actually, when I first started transitioning into culinary with that $10 an hour job, what I found to be my strength was that the place where I was working, I could also manage their numbers. So I instantly became managing their budget, creating a budget because they had no budget.
Okay.
And
so a lot of people have the passion, but they don't have the business drive.
Right, or the knowledge to kind of manage those things. Like, and that's with most artistries, though.
Right.
If you think about that, right? Like, you think about beauticians, right?
Okay.
So you can do hair, but it doesn't necessarily mean you can want to.
Who we have in the building speaking of hair?
Yeah.
What's the name?
So, you know, the same thing. You can cook, but that doesn't necessarily mean you can run a restaurant or run a catering business or, you know, whatever that is.
Being a talent, but just that's it.
Yeah, and that's cool.
Yeah.
And that's perfectly fine because in the end, you're an artist, right?
Right.
And that's fine. But I think my strength and what probably separates me from other chefs is that I may not have as much experience in the kitchen professionally as some of these guys have been in kitchens for 15 or 20 years.
Okay.
But I definitely have figured out the business component and how to blend those two to be successful.
Okay. So let's say, and I'm not, just for the record, okay? But let's say that I am a new entrepreneur and I have a passion for cooking,
right?
But I am not college educated. I just know how to cook my ass off.
Right.
And I heard about you or I heard about you through this feed and I want to come to you. What would that conversation look like?
So my team is a team of chefs. It's not just me. Kitchen Killer Culinary Solutions is a team of chefs. So it's me, but it's also other chefs who can stand in when I'm not there, who are my backup when I am there. And then also we, you know, like you were saying, I offer food service consulting.
Okay.
So we do a number of
food service consulting.
Yeah.
I'm so sorry. I know I keep stopping, but this is all new for me. So I want to break it down because it's new for me. I know it's new for a lot of my viewers. So food consulting, what is that?
So that's much of what I talked about before, coming into whether it be a restaurant or a facility that has a commercial kitchen, a residential facility where people live and they feed them. Independent charter schools, things like that.
Okay,
we go into
facilities
that have independent kitchens. Yeah, they have independent kitchens. So we are able to help them manage their costs, help them with product procurement, help them order, help them manage their food costs, labor, staffing, hiring, all of those things. So the things that people don't necessarily think about when they are buying food. It's like, oh, all I got to do is buy food and cook it and serve it. No, but have you managed your shrink? Do you know how much food waste you create off the products that you're buying? So that's a service that we offer.
You know what I like about this? And it's making sense to me. And thank you so much for breaking it down like a fifth grader. It's making sense to me because a lot of times, you're right, as an artist, you are so consumed with just the craft.
Right.
And you're good at what you do.
and you want to monetize it, but you just don't know where to go. You have no options. You're not quite sure of the outlet or if it's even a service that's offered. So basically what you're saying is that you are a company that if I am a talent, I can come to you and you can monetize my talent.
For
is that
sure.
correct?
Yeah, absolutely. We can do that. Or you can join the Kitchen Killer team and be one of our chefs who go out and do one of our events. We do private events like in-home private dinners. We do dinners for two, dinners for 20. We do brunches, baby showers, weddings. We are preferred vendors at some of the best venues in South Florida.
Mm-hmm.
So weddings for 200. We do corporate events at various companies in South Florida. So we absolutely can do all of those things.
That's good to know. Thank you for sharing that with my viewers, because I think, you know what, even in the producing industry as well, there are a lot of people that, you know, want to do podcasting as an example, and, you know, they speak very well. My best friend, she's amazing. Like, she entertains me via WhatsApp chat every single day, and, you know, but she's not that one that, you know, technically savvy. So to find someone that can actually take her passion and monetize it, it's what you do in the culinary side. So let's pop it up for that, guys. I'm taking that. Okay, so I want to, we are going to be in the kitchen. So I'm going to, I have some questions for you that we're going to actually kind of stick to in the kitchen. But I just want to ask you really quickly, because I think a lot of people have missed. Nah, if I show a titty, it's okay. Because Janet did it. I know. I feel it happening. Janet did it, and big things happen for her. So I just want to go
here. I told you to Janet before she did it.
But,
I'm just saying.
That way. You don't have to do that. You bugged out with Shady. Y'all fucked with Shady with that one, right? Shady, no Shady. You saw that one, right? Okay. So one of the things that I wanted to kind of ask you, if you don't mind, you know, a little personal. Okay with that? Because we're all all the way live show.
Okay.
Hey mama. So so talk to me about what are some things you cook, or do you even cook at home?
I work a lot. And particularly with the client that I have now, I work a lot.
Okay.
And when I come home, I don't necessarily want to cook. And I'm hardly ever home. Yeah. I mean, it's like, you know, if you were a teacher and you taught all day, do you want to come home and teach more kids? Not so much.
But I mean, teaching and cooking is two different things.
So, but I do occasionally cook at home. When I do cook, it's typically because, you know, either I got a cool recipe that I want to try out.
Okay.
Or sometimes I'm just inspired. There's sometimes I'll leave the kitchen and maybe I fumbled something in the kitchen.
Okay.
And now I'm pissed off and I need to do it again. So I go home and do it again.
So they're guinea pigs. You're not really cooking from passion and love.
No, it depends. It depends on the time. It depends on the space, for sure. I cook. And then also, you know, the holidays are coming up. So I cook.
Yes.
You know, I cook for the family sometimes. Whenever we can get together, you know, my parents, my brother, I try to cook for them because I know they appreciate
favorite
it.
Favorite dish?
It varies. It varies on the week. You know, it really does. Like, my mom loves the seafood chowder that I do.
Seafood chowder.
Yeah.
Okay. White chowder or red chowder?
It's a white chowder.
Okay. Is there such thing as a red chowder? Did I fuck that up?
No, they're not red chowder. Yeah, so it depends. Right now I'm on tuna bowls.
Okay.
The client I have now, I just made him a seared tuna bowl and he loved it. He wants it again. So
and you have celebrity clients.
I got a couple clients.
Oh wait, tuna. Don't be humble. First of all, let's talk about these edges, though, because you know I'm going to keep the edges. Yes, I'm delayed to the gods. Did you do that for me?
Yeah.
Good answer. Thank you. I appreciate that. Okay, so we are going to be going into the kitchen. A lot of my questions, I know we have a lot of prep time and stuff we're going to be doing in the kitchen, so a lot of my questions are going to be in there,
mm-hmm.
and we're going to definitely dive a little bit. And, of course, for our viewers, if you have any questions for her, make sure you guys tune in so that you guys can ask her questions. We have some holiday questions for you. So do you remember?
Hold on.
So you remember on Instagram, right? So you remember on Instagram, right?
Uh-huh.
When you had put a post, you was like, "Oh, I'm getting me a custom made apron for my TV takeover show."
Right.
Excuse me. So I have a little surprise for you.
Oh.
Remember the surprise I was telling you guys about? I got my own little custom made.
Okay.
Just for you. Bam! Y'all ain't ready. Y'all ready for the kitchen? Are you ready for the kitchen? Episode 7.
Okay.
I'm gonna have all our panelists sign on it. Awesome. So that you get some love, and then you're gonna get to take it home. That's the gift for you.
That's awesome.
Okay. So I know you got some prepping to do. I'm a little ramble for this. So speaking of rainbow colors,
oh god,
do you like rainbow colors?
I do like rainbow colors.
What about rainbow colors you like?
I love all colors.
Yeah, which one of the rainbow colors do you appreciate the most?
Oh,
the yellow. Bitch.
Thank
you. It's yellow. All right, so this is, I'm gonna give you
like kitchen killer red too.
You like that?
Kitchen killer red.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay. So listen, so we have I'm gonna introduce the audience a little bit to our influencer panelists. We actually have some pretty heavy hitters.
I see.
I don't know, you don't brought everybody to the building.
My team brought that.
You brought everybody to the building. So I'm gonna give you an opportunity to go ahead and put your apron on, get yourself all prepared, pull up your sleeves, and then we're gonna be over there in a second. I'm gonna put my apron on.
Are you coming to cook too?
I'm not cooking, but I'm going to drink and watch you cook.
With the apron on.
With the apron on.
Oh, so you're fake cooking.
Fake cooking. I'm okay with fake cooking.
Okay, that's cool.
All right. And you know what's awesome, and I appreciate it, because you know I'm a pescatarian, and we have one of our panelists that are pescatarian as well. So not only are you going to be doing a dish for the non-pescatarian people, but for the carnivore as well. So I'm super excited. Guys, stay tuned. Now remember, this is live, bitches. So we're going to transition and do some stuff, and I don't know how this is going to work out. Don't be sending me no shit about you. Girl, your shit was packed. Okay, it's live. All right, it's live. All right, walk out to the kitchen. All right, we're gonna go to the kitchen. Give me a second with my apron on. Can we get some music, DJ? I want to hear some wings, bangs, the bangs, the bells. I love that song. I don't know why, but it just does something to my soul. Put on my apron. I made this myself, guys. Are you guys ready? Are you guys ready? We're about to go in the kitchen. Hey! You're about to go in the kitchen. I made it from scratch. All right, guys, we're going to go into the kitchen. We're going to go ahead and see. You know, let me go ahead and take a look at my influencers. I'm not going to give you a full introduction yet. I'm just going to have you guys look at how pretty they are. Cameraman, you want to go ahead and show how beautiful our guests are? And who we got in the building? Look. Look at the oh, hi, guys. Y'all, we got Mary J. Blige in the building. Hey, Mary. Oh, my God. So I'm going to give you guys a formal introduction a little bit. I'm going to go over to our kitchen, Kiara, and then come back and forth. I've been drinking. Let me tell you something. Upraiser party got me fucked up. I ain't going to lie. I'm not. It is what it is. All right. So are you allowed to tell me what you're cooking?
Yeah, so today we're doing a little brunch after dark situation,
right? Well, so brunch is like the end thing now, isn't it?
Yeah, brunch has been the end thing. I mean, I like brunch, so for me, it's been the end thing.
Okay.
So today we're doing a maple turkey apple skillet. Yeah, so it's going to have sweet potatoes, it'll have kale, it'll have some apples, some Honeycrisp apples, ground turkey, and then we're going to sweeten it a little bit with herbs and maple syrup.
Okay.
Mess over here.
All right, so I'm going to be asking you some random questions, okay? These are some questions that some of the viewers put in, so it might be a little bit nasty. I'm sorry. It's not my fault.
Yeah, my mama watching.
Oh, hey, mama. So you know what the first thing I want to ask you, because we do have an influencer panel. Mm-hmm. And when I was doing some research, there was actually a lot of really mixed reviews on how chefs felt about critics. What's your thoughts on critics? What do you think about them?
I feed people to make them happy.
Okay.
You know, I don't work in a, you know, 5-star James Beard restaurant. So yeah. I'm certain that chefs who live that restaurant life likely have a different opinion on critics. For me, a critic is someone who's eaten my food and
You've eaten my food because I've chosen for you to eat.
Okay.
Right? And I cook because I want to feed people. So, you know, how do I feel about critics? I mean, if I'm doing what I'm supposed to do, then I love them.
So just so that you know, there are some people that feel as though that it's a huge mistake to give so much power to people who know nothing about the industry. That's what a lot of, I was actually surprised. Do you agree with that or no? Or
yeah, it depends. But again, I think that's in any industry across the board, right? Mm-hmm. There are critics in movies. There's critics in, you know, even if you work in retail, who's your biggest critic? Your immediate supervisor.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, you know, whether or not those people have experience or have talent or whatever the case may be, it's really about how you put yourself in a position to be judged by those people, right? You know,
like you sure can.
No, I'm not. I like your little fancy cutting board.
I got that just for you. Bed Bath & Beyond, $24.99. Okay, so you ready for some random questions? They're gonna be real random. All right. How do you keep from crying when cutting onions? I thought they were real random.
Yeah. So
it's legit shit, because I know I wanna know.
How do I keep from crying? For me, keeping my knife sharp.
Okay.
Because it's something about, and forgive me if I'm not like terribly specific with this, but it's something about the pores in an onion.
Okay.
If your knife is sharp, it'll cut straight through them. When you start tearing the onion, then that's when all those different enzymes and things kind of start kicking back and making you cry. Also, I wear contacts, so it keeps my eyes naturally dry.
Okay.
When I don't have my contacts in, then I cry. You know,
it
waters your eyes. So
interesting. I didn't. So yeah, having a good knife.
Yeah, having a good knife.
And how you cut it. You guys got that?
Right.
Y'all think you know?
I knew that.
Shut up.
Okay.
You ain't know that.
I don't cry. It's all about how you cut it.
Okay. My best thing knows some shit. Okay. What part of the green onion, the scallion, do you use? Any question for me?
I use it all. It depends on the dish. Depends on what part I'm using it for. So, for instance, if I'm making like a soup and there's like mirepoix. So mirepoix is like the onions, the carrots, the celery that you put at the base of that.
Okay.
Excuse me. I use the white part.
Okay.
If I'm garnishing, if I'm using it to kind of finish a dish, right? It goes in at the end, then it's the green part. If I'm making like stews or soups or stocks, then I throw the whole thing in there.
Interesting. Yeah. I didn't know that. Okay. All right. Favorite celebrity chef.
I have to go with Chef Robles.
Robles, who's that? I haven't heard that one.
Y'all know Robles?
Yeah, you got Robles? Yeah. All right, talk about it.
I like Robles. I've actually had an opportunity to cook with Robles twice, I think.
Oh, that's awesome.
When he came down.
Robles, if you're watching, hi!
No, I like Robles because he's really, really cool. He's a young guy. He's from Brooklyn, I think.
Okay.
And he is just himself in the kitchen. He wears what he wants. He does what he wants. He talks how he wants to talk. And there's no, you know, no pretension. He's just a cool dude, and his food is great. His food is great.
All right. Favorite ingredient to work with?
I like herbs.
Other than Joey. I'm an ingredient.
Okay. I like herbs. I think herbs are really, really important when you're cooking because you can find, you can use.
I'm sorry. So I just have to say this. And I know this was a private moment between you and I, but I gotta tell the people how you was talking about. I don't know why you got this cutting board. It's all cute and stuff, but I don't know what I'm gonna do with all of this. You like it now.
What did
you?
I do though? I found you sport.
You did?
I did.
You did? Can I get an apology on camera?
You know what, Jody? I'm so sorry. I did not find the usefulness of your cutting board, your fancy cutting board.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, I just had to put it out there. Because you know, you made me feel some type of way. Like,
not
I thought I was doing something. I knew it! What is this, by the way? What is
this
that?
This is rosemary. Okay. Rosemary. Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, I like cooking with spices. Because, well, with herbs, rather. Because.
Do you like it in the containers or natural?
I mean, fresh herbs are always the best. Okay. Because you just said you smell it, right?
Right, yeah.
Do you ever smell stuff when you open it out the container?
Rarely.
Rarely, right?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it gives you that fragrance. It
can I dump these or we go somewhere else?
No, you can dump them.
Okay, I'm going to go out in the kitchen.
Oh, so your apron's getting some
juice. Yeah, I'm going to, you know, sometimes I'm going to be cute with it. You know, it's going to work. Okay. So, you like fresh. All right.
I like herbs because when you have to omit things like salt or pepper, or butter, mm-hmm. things like that, then those herbs kind of make up for that.
The natural ones.
Right.
Awesome. That makes sense. Because you're right, they do have a lot of additives and stuff like that. Okay. Right. Place that you eat most on your days off.
Ooh. I'm a sushi eater. I'm an oyster eater.
Me too!
Yeah. I love
oysters. So, yeah, where do you go?
Bubbles and Pearls and Wilton Manor is one of my favorites.
Okay, shout out to Bubbles and Pearls and Wilton Manor.
Bubbles and Pearls. Marcy's the owner there, and Chef Josie. They got great product there.
Yeah.
Great oysters, great selection. It's usually pretty random whenever you go there. It's always something different. And they're really, really nice. It's a really cool environment.
Wilton Manor.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah, okay. Last weekend on Earth, what city are you eating in?
New York.
Why?
There's just so many options.
Right.
There's just so many options,
okay.
You know?
Okay.
Yeah, there's options.
But what about, so in New York, it's going to be virtual. I'm a seafood person. Maybe this is why I'm a little bit biased, right? Mm-hmm. And I feel as though, because I lived in Utah for about a year, and mm-hmm. while they have some great chefs over there, mm-hmm. they really could not get their hands on fresh seafood for right. obvious reasons. So for me, when I think of New York, where are you going to get fresh seafood from? It's going to have to be imported.
True. But yeah. I don't necessarily need fresh seafood. I mean, I like all kinds of food. I like Korean food. I like, you know, what I like is the melting pot of the cuisine, you know? Mm. So I know that I can walk out any street and go eat Italian, go eat Thai, go eat Filipino, go, you know, whatever.
Okay. Makes sense. All right. Most embarrassing cooking moment outside of me being here with you. Most embarrassing cooking moment.
Question. I don't know. I mean, I've burnt many things on many occasions, you know, so it would likely have to be one of those. But I kind of save stuff. I mean, just recently I thought I burnt something because I didn't check it and then I saved it. So, you know, it's only embarrassing if you let people know that you fumbled it.
True.
You know what I'm saying?
True, true.
So it's about, you know, how well you can kind of recover.
Okay. Person you would most like to cook for,
Beyonce.
Why Beyonce? Other than that, she's on.
Wait, and then that.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah, tell me why. And what would you cook for them, Janet? Whoa. What would you cook for Janet Jackson and Beyonce?
Whatever she wanted me to cook. Whatever she wanted me to cook, I would.
But if you want to,
I go buy the whole store.
Good. What can you do?
Let's see.
Oh my See? God, it smells amazing.
I go by the whole store okay. and then just stand there and let her give me orders and tell me what she wants. That's how that would go.
You know, don't let me go there. All right, so whatever, okay, if you really wanted to impress them, when you really think about everything that you've done,
right.
what would it be?
It would probably
if she be- said to you, you know what, killer,
just
do your thing, girl. That's me being
Janet. Right.
What would it be?
She got a whisper. All right, so I would probably make her like a scallop and gnocchi dish, you know, seared scallops, with the cognac sauce. And some gnocchi with spinach. That kind of stuff. Mm. Yeah, so it's not too heavy, not too light.
Okay. All right. Now, do you think that there is an advantage or a disadvantage as a woman chef?
Again, I think it's about the industry. I think chefing and being in the culinary industry has so many different opportunities, you know, whether you're in a restaurant, whether you're working independently. And I'm a firm believer of independent working being just that. It's independent. So you kind of choose how prominent or how exposed you're going to be. And so, you know, what I will say is that I have not come across, at least not knowingly, a situation where, you know, I didn't get it because I was a female.
Okay.
Or, you know.
Maybe because you're just that dope.
It could be. I mean, I recognize that there are issues in all industries,
right,
you know,
right.
where there are disadvantages. But do I feel like I'm at a disadvantage?
Right.
I mean, I think I can create advantages. So
I like that.
Whatever
creating advantages.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Okay, so I want to tap in a little bit to some of the business side that we kind of talked a little bit about. What are three tips you think, or what are three tips that you would give for running a successful restaurant?
Three tips I think for running a successful restaurant. First, having a fresh menu. Okay. Having a menu that is different, okay, that people can't get other places. Having great customer service. Having something unique where people know they can't get it other places as far as the service.
Okay.
And then also, excuse me, great food. And then from the restaurant, can I give you four then, I guess?
Yeah, yeah.
From the restaurant standpoint, obviously managing your costs.
Okay.
It's really important that you are making money. I mean, it's not enough to just be selling food and to have people in your restaurant, but it's also important to sell and to make money in the process. So making sure that your margins are set appropriately.
Okay. Now, can I ask you a quick question?
Sure.
Real random. You asked me to get Gala apples. Why the fuck? Why couldn't you get Granny Smith? What is it about Gala apples? Why? You know.
Well, it's apple season now,
okay,
and so they are kind of at their peak as far as sweetness.
Oh, okay.
But they're also not as sweet and not as tart as some of the others. Like, personally, if I'm going to eat an apple, I like Honeycrisp apples.
Okay.
But for something like this, you don't want them super, super sweet.
Okay.
But you don't want them as tart as some of the other apples either.
Okay. Where do you get your ingredients? I think it's always good to know. I remember I think I texted you a couple of times. Like, girl, yeah, where do you get this? Where should I get that?
You know, some of the best local markets have some of the best product.
Okay.
So local farmer markets are cool. And then if you find other stores like Lucky Market or Fresh Market, Whole Foods, Aldi, for produce.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for sure. And it also depends on whether or not you're trying to shop cost efficiently,
okay,
or if you're trying to shop for variety. So places like Aldi are going to give you cost efficiency, but places like Lucky Market will give you a larger variety.
Okay. Did you guys know that? I hope y'all taking notes. Cause I'm trying to help y'all grocery bills because the holidays are coming up. What was your biggest mistake when you were a brand new chef?
Probably getting comfortable with items I knew people would like already.
Okay.
And just not studying enough, not building my own knowledge, and that's kind of like the pros and cons. It's a pro and a con of working independently.
Okay.
Because you aren't around other chefs, so you don't get to learn as much, right? You don't get the best practices. You don't get the, hey, don't do that because I've already done it. So you kind of have to learn on your own. That being said, you have to be in charge of your own growth and development.
Okay.
And so you have to study. You have to learn. You have to research. And if you don't do that, you stay stagnant. And you don't become one of the most
popular. So I'm supposed to cut those off?
Well, I'm just doing
it. Maybe I'm sorry. I'm supposed to cut off the tips. And
I cut off the tips because that way when I'm cutting it, it doesn't roll around, right? So if I tried to cut that, I probably cut my finger off trying to roll it because it's rolling all over the place.
Okay.
So if I create a flat base, then it's easier for me to cut.
Makes sense. All right. What is the one ingredient that you cannot live without?
Salt.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm surprised to hear that, actually.
Yeah.
Tell me why.
Well, I mean, salt in moderation. It's flavor, and if you know how to season appropriately, then it's going to build your flavors. Nobody wants to eat without salt. Nobody, you know, willingly. But you know, honestly, within moderation, it's always very important. Because whenever you are attempting to eat healthy, that's kind of the first thing that they tell you to cut out. It's salt because it bloats you. You know, you retain more water, that kind of stuff.
Right.
So,
right.
But I mean, and my business is cooking flavorful. You know, and if that's my goal, then salt's kind of the start of that.
Okay. Do you find yourself being challenged when you have someone that is a vegan or someone that is a pescatarian? Is that challenging for you, or what are some of the things, what are your go-tos?
Yeah, anytime you have a client who has culinary or dietary restrictions, it's a challenge.
Okay.
because it's not a challenge to create it, but it's a challenge to also make it something that's still that they're gonna like, that they're gonna love, and not just going with throwing a salad in front of them.
True.
You know what I mean?
True.
So yeah, sure, it's a challenge, but there's always things you can do when you have pescatarians, when you have vegans. Mm-hmm. I think any dish can be turned into a vegan dish.
Or, really?
Yeah. I mean, we can change all those things regularly.
That's interesting. Okay, so can you walk me through that a little bit? So you said pretty much any dish can be.
Give me a dish.
Okay, guys, give me a dish. Give me a
spaghetti and meatballs.
Spaghetti and meatballs.
I can't solve fish.
That is pescatarian.
No, vegan.
Oh, vegan. Oh, okay.
Okay.
So we have spaghetti and meatballs and I can't solve fish.
So spaghetti and meatballs. Spaghetti, if you're using tempeh, which is like a meat substitute, you can use tempeh to give you that meat texture. And then there's tons of vegan pastas out there that you can use as a substitute. Tomato sauces are easy to use as a vegan dish because all you have to do is substitute. If you're using butter in your base, you just substitute butter for the olive oil. So those are simple.
Okay.
What was the other one?
Ackee and saltfish. She just wanted to be different.
Yeah, I know. I have no idea.
I knew what she was going to say. Yes.
What is it?
Jackfruit.
Jackfruit is a common meat substitute.
Okay.
It's obviously not going to give you the fishy seafood flavor or taste or texture. But jackfruit is definitely a good pork or beef or even chicken substitute.
I don't know. I've never really been able to get too much into the jackfruit thing, because just like you said, you know, because it's what I'm looking for, a fishy flavor, and I get fruity. It kind of throws me off. Like it would depend on how that would work. Okay. So we're gonna talk a little bit about the holidays coming. Now you actually have something that you're doing for Thanksgiving, because a lot of us out there, guys, we understand that the Thanksgiving holidays are the time to cook for family. We have the days off from work, but not all of us really want to cook. And you're doing something absolutely amazing, which is super, super affordable. Mm-hmm. You want to talk a little bit about what it is you're doing for the Thanksgiving, what you're offering?
Sure. So what we've kind of gotten away from is, taking initially in the past for Thanksgiving, we've been taking bids or just kind of first come, first serve when it comes to booking us for Thanksgiving. Mm-hmm. And so instead, what I wanted to do is create an opportunity where everyone can kind of have a kitchen killer Thanksgiving. So
kitchen killer Thanksgiving.
Yeah. So my team and I created a menu, and it's available to order. So basically you place your order anytime between now and November 18th, I think, is the date. Okay. Sunday the 18th.
And I think my producer is going to be putting up the links in the website for all that information.
Yeah. So you have your choice of four different turkeys. So you can pick from a turkey, and then we got a bunch of really cool sides on the who's filming that? That's the dope picture.
You like that?
Yeah.
So we gave you.
Yeah.
Killing it.
So yeah, we got a choice of sides. It's a sweet potato souffle. We got turkey collard greens, mac and cheese, smoked Gouda mac and cheese.
Wait, pause.
Yeah.
Smoked. Hold on. I'm sorry. Can I
go there? Go ahead.
I don't think I remember seeing that on there, babe. Can we do this? Smoked Gouda. What else?
Smoked Gouda mac and cheese.
Mac and cheese.
That's sweet potato souffle.
Okay.
And then I believe on that menu we are doing.
So we got pineapple Ciroc ham,
mm-hmm.
maple brown sugar ham.
So all that stuff is on the a la carte menu.
Okay.
So what I was naming before was like the family menu. There's a family menu.
That's this on the side. Yeah. Turkey collard greens.
So it's just price fixed. You order for either four or for eight.
So dinner for four.
Uh-huh.
Carol, this is actually a really good price. $195? Girl, who you know in public? So, okay, guys, just that for those of you that don't know. So for dinner for four, okay, you don't want to cook, which I am that one. Dinner for four, guys, is $195. But check out what you get with it. You get to select a turkey flavor. We have lemon pepper turkey, killer dry rub oven baked turkey, smoked jerk turkey, or bourbon pecan turkey, bitch. Girl, you are giving these people a lot for this $195.
You gotta pick one turkey. You don't get all four.
I know, but still, this is some high class shit. Okay, and on the side, we have turkey collard greens, smoked Gouda mac. I have to try this smoked Gouda mac. I need to try that. Babe, cash app her.
I got you.
honey butter, cornbread. My bestie don't love that one. She loves cornbread. Southern dressing, candied pecan, sweet potato souffle, sweet potato cheesecake. Bitch, what? spiced cinnamon apple cider. Wow. So dinner for four is $195. Dinner for eight is $395. Now, I'm going to tell you, I don't know how you're able to do all of that, because when I look at even just kind of sort of guess what the ingredients are that are required for all of this, this is a great deal, guys. The information is on the line. If you don't feel like cooking Thanksgiving dinner for either yourself and your immediate family, or for a dinner of eight, do you do more? What if it's like 16?
Yes. Double it? So what's cool is that you can either order for four, you can order for eight, and then in addition to that, we have a separate menu, an a la carte menu.
Got it.
So you can double up those orders, or you can order from the a la carte menu with a list of completely totally different menu items. So you can add to those orders if you need to stretch. Or even if you don't need the whole meal, right? Sometimes you are going to your family's house and you just need to bring a dish, but you don't even want to do that.
So can I talk about these sides real quick?
Go ahead.
White chocolate Hennessy.
Yeah. Bread. That's kind of our staple. Our bread puddings are our staples, our kitchen killer staples.
Do we have orders for that already? I think so.
I'll bring that out for Thanksgiving.
Douce, caramel, peach, cobbler, sweet potato, cheesecake, spiked cinnamon, apple cider. Kitchen Killer, you're doing your thing on this.
I'm trying to do a little something.
Yeah. So, guys, for that information, make sure you click on those links. This is amazing. And these prices are unbeatable. Because I think, you know, when you think about Honey Ham, Wendy, listen, I'm saying right now, if you ask me to bring shit for Thanksgiving this year, bitch, I'm hollering at Kitchen Killer. I'm saying right now.
No, I'm
just like, go ahead and pick which one you want.
Talking about Thanksgiving, like, we might just gonna have to do Kitchen Killer.
Just do Kitchen Killer. Like, we're having a Kitchen Killer Thanksgiving, guys. I don't know about you, but you may want to get on that because, hello, and not have to be in the kitchen? At all? Sweating out this good perm? Not really. But you know what I'm saying? You know? So, yeah, this is amazing. Thank you so much. I'm really appreciating that. So, are you going to do some stuff over there? Can I talk to some of our panelists?
For sure. Go ahead.
We have an amazing influencer that we're going to be introducing to. So, come on, guys. Follow me. Well, you guys know, I already told you, we got Mary J. Blige in the building. No, this is Andy. Andy is actually a really great friend of ours. And Andy is someone that she is, as a single woman, you love to actually eat out and enjoy and taste different things. Yes. So are you excited about trying out this brunch?
Absolutely, because I'm not cooking.
You're not cooking?
Yeah.
So you may want to holler at that Thanksgiving dinner thing that she got going on. That sounds pretty good. $195 for four people?
Absolutely.
Get it together. We'll upgrade the party. Maybe we can do a little upgrade the party.
Yeah.
Right. But actually, with your meal today, Kitchen Killer actually has a special brunch drink. So I'm really excited about that. Guys, this is a special guest. Well, they're all special. We have in the building Miss Darcell. Darcell, guys, is actually a producer for Special Project with WSBN. Yes, bitches, that's Channel 7 in the house, in the building. She is actually responsible for, how did you guys know about Bite with Belky? You guys know about Bite with Belky on Channel 7?
Yes.
She is the one responsible for that. Let's clap it up for that. So as far as being a foodie and someone that absolutely knows what they're talking about, girl, we know you're going to keep it real with us today. All right. Let's go ahead and move over now. Y'all didn't see her entire outfit. You know how to do it. Hey, boo. So we have in the building, this is Miss Siobhan. Miss Siobhan is the editor-in-chief for Bossy Magazine. Absolutely. And as well as a foodie, she is going to be absolutely instrumental in giving us some great feedback on what we're going to be doing. Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Yeah, it's going to be good.
Yeah,
and you look good. Y'all got to see the show, honey. Maybe you want the pictures afterwards. About last night picture, I'm gonna show y'all what she got on. Next here we have a bunch of you guys will know this is a really good friend of mine as well. Miss Coco. So Coco is actually a meal prep guru.
She's a personal chef. She's currently in culinary school studying plant-based vegetarian specialty. She has a company called Hello Itis Meal Prep. Now, one of the things that I think I really like about what you're doing is I used to do the meal prep because, you know, my cooking was crazy. A lot of times I didn't have a lot of time to cook. But the reason that I backed out from some of these companies is they didn't have a lot of options for vegans, vegetarians, and pescatarians. That's your specialty, bitch. Get it together. Hurry up, because I need it. So definitely, something, of course, her information is going to be available to you guys to be on the timeline. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here. Are you excited to see?
Yes.
Are you excited to taste? My ass will get light. You know I have big booty coming out. So we have in the building, we have some testosterone in the building. Mr. Donald has an IT background, but he actually himself is a foodie.
I am.
Whenever I call him, he's always at some different type of food event. What were you at recently?
Went to Miami Spice.
Are you ready to taste the chicken?
Oh.
Oh, absolutely. Guys, make sure you keep it real with her, okay? Because feedback is a gift, damn it. All right. Thank you so much for coming, darling.
Thank you for having me.
Yes. First of all, it's that hairstyle is everything. One time for the bald head, y'all. One time for the bald head. So who do we have here? We have Miss Suzette. Miss Suzette is the CEO of Uncommon Marketing and founder of the Social Media for Entertainers. So you are actually someone that would be able to not only get great feedback here, but for anybody that is interested, reaching out to her to figure out how to market your business. You know, right now it's all about social media. So we're going to be talking. It's all about social media. It's all about, like what Kiara said, taking your passion and being able to monetize it, how to do that. And I know that you have been someone that has been instrumental. Did you guys show them a red carpet or yellow carpet, purple carpet, white carpet? What was it?
Love until it hurts.
Okay.
The film that's being released.
Okay.
And I think actually, Christy, you were in it, right?
Yes. She was on our episode 6
right.
For Boss Ladies.
Right.
Absolutely. Doing yeah. Big things.
And I'm with friends with Kim Wyatt and supporting her.
Nice. Are you excited to taste the Chiara? Well, we are excited as well. So, guys, she is in there cooking. Girl, you back? Oh, no, she ain't there. I had to make sure. So we got Upgrade Your Party making us drinks, and we are going to go back in the kitchen a little bit, talk to her a little bit about it. Did you guys have any questions for her? Holidays are coming up. We have any questions? Let me see.
I think I might hurt.
So Sue, she wants to know about your night action. And I agree. I think a lot of people actually, for me personally, when I look at Chef, that's one of the first things that I notice is the night action. Kiara,
yes.
Night action.
About it.
Tell us about it. How you don't cut your fingers off?
Well, again, in culinary school, one of the very first things they teach you is how to hold a knife, how to use the knife, how to keep your knife sharp, because a sharp knife or a dull knife is a dangerous knife.
Okay.
Right? That's any chef, anybody in the culinary industry will tell you that. A dull knife is a dangerous knife. So the harder you have to work with your knife, the more likely you're going to also chop your finger with your food, you know?
Great question.
So yeah, sharp knives are always good. And then
suggest having a knife sharpener always?
Having a knife sharpener. I use a couple different vendors who actually come to me and sharpen my knives.
We ain't got your kind of budget.
No.
Bring it on back. All right. Some of our special people to sharpen your knife. I have to give a shout out really quickly. So my baby brother, shout out to
Francois,
if you're watching, my baby brother, I love you, I love you, I love you. My brother actually went to the Culinary Institute of America in Hyde Park, New York, and he is a celebrity chef himself. He couldn't make it because he's busy. His beautiful queen is also a pastry chef from South Africa, and we're going to hopefully try to get him on the show a little bit later. But one of the things that I did notice is he spends bread on his knife. Like, he has a $600 knife. Okay, $600 knife. So I definitely do hear that. But great question. Thank you so much. Any other questions for Kitchen Killer? How are they cooking? You ain't cooking. You more than 1.5 meal. I already see it. When I said you want a day to cook, you don't tell me. Kitchen Killer, that's okay. Kitchen. There we go. That's what it is. We have a question in the audience. What's your question, darling?
She keeps talking about the
okay. wait so long.
Oh, we got
secret killer.
We trying to reveal secrets.
We would like to know. I was trying to be nice because I've been known to be a little bit of a bully at times. But, you know, when we talk about passion in the kitchen,
right?
Talk about passion, and I talk about love. So, who are you cooking for in the kitchen?
I thought we were talking about my clients. I do love cooking for my clients, though.
So, who are you cooking for in the kitchen? Come on,
fill
the team. This is your
time.
You won't reel it all the way down.
So, what's awesome is that you guys, I talk a lot about my team, the cooking for the team, because there's a team of us.
Okay.
Kind of create meals and go out and do things when I'm not available.
Okay.
And that's because right now there's basketball season. I'm cooking for my new pizza song.
You better motherfucker. Pause. I didn't expect that. Pause. Get your killer. What's bitch. Up? Wait a minute. Pause. Babe, you heard that? So wait a minute. For those of you that missed it, I want to be clear in making sure that I heard it correctly. Can you pull off? All right, let's go back. So who are you cooking for, ma'am? But I know it's just going to be an hour. Don't look at me like that. I cook for her. Don't do me. Baby, don't cook for you. Tell her. Thank you. So, but you have to do this all day. So, first of all, what time do you wake up? Let's start there and then just run me through your day.
So, it really depends on his schedule. So, my schedule is his schedule, essentially.
Okay.
If it's a game day, then it's a pregame, a pre-shoot around smoothie or food station or food bar or food bowl. I'm sorry. And then lunch after shoot around, a pregame meal. He has a particular snack that he likes. And then it's a really late night. So after the game, whenever there's a home game, dinner's at like 11:30 p.m. And then we start all over again. So it could be breakfast at 9, lunch at 3, lunch at 9 or 10. But it's really, really long days, 15, 16, 17 hour days.
Because you're responsible for everything they're consuming.
Snacks, smoothies, fruit bowls. Everything. You get hungry, you want PB&J.
That's you.
That's me.
Wow.
Yes.
That's
PB&J.
Right. She said PB&J.
So like a regular one?
Right.
Special.
So we have
then move them right to the oven. And so I just dropped a couple eggs on top.
Okay, well, we have the oven on what?
Oven's on 375.
Okay.
Look at you clean your oven.
Bitch, I did that for you.
Ooh, I appreciate
I'll
that.
I put that motherfucker on oven clean. Are you shitting that shit? Because you know what? Okay, first of all, we were shouting out to my best friend. She called me yesterday. She's like, bitch, did you clean the kitchen properly? Did you clean the stove? You know, but like she broke it down for me. But shout out to me and my bestie. She was like, she made sure. Good job, Wendy. She made sure that my stove was on point for you. And that, you know, sometimes you got lots of more hard, but little details you missed out. And bitch, that would have been a messy oven if I had it. So shout out. They just they did pictures and video and everything. Yeah, I was so embarrassed. Thank you. Thank you. Okay, so we put it over for how long?
So those are gonna kind of cook just on site until those eggs look how I want them to look.
Okay.
But usually it takes about 10 to 12 minutes.
Okay.
And they're gonna be sunny side up eggs right on top.
Okay.
You can serve them just like that right on there.
So I know you said that you have a specialty drink as well. Like
yeah, I wouldn't necessarily call it a specialty drink, but I'm not.
You call it a specialty drink today.
Oh, okay. Special.
You're special.
Oh,
I have your apron. Is that for me too?
Is it for me? No, I got a really cool seamstress, fashion major. Yeah, so she
wanna give a shout out.
Yeah, I mean, you brought it up.
Because if you don't know,
so she made it custom for you. So I love it.
Nice.
I love anything kitchen to shoot.
Nice.
Fashion major.
Fashion major. Shout out to fashion major.
Yeah.
We appreciate you. Honestly, you inspired me.
Look at that.
You inspired me.
We're gonna get fashion major one.
Yeah, wow, okay.
I mean, I'd like to say
that you don't
want
to. But, you know, she can upgrade you. Because I was going to have everybody sign it.
Oh,
you heard my feelings.
I'm going to put it in a frame on the wall. I'm going to put it in the house.
When you go to one of my meetings, tell Gabrielle that any time in my life, you happen to see her or meet her, just say, hey, just throw her my card and just say, Jody says hi.
Like that.
I mean,
I want to keep a job though. You know
right,
what I'm saying?
You're right. Okay. So,
but I'm telling you,
make sure you do.
Okay.
And then, or you can FaceTime me. I don't have an iPhone, but we can pretend.
Okay. What's that?
What's that? Okay.
Yeah, for sure.
All right. Well, listen, seriously though, congratulations on that client. That's awesome. Thank you. You're doing big things.
Hope to have a really great, healthy season.
No, we are. We are. Awesome. But I will blame you.
Do I get the praise if he's doing it? Yes.
So far, so good. So now we know that the reason that he is playing amazingly well is because he's being nourished by none other than the Kitchen Killer. Let's clap for Kitchen Killer. All right. Thanksgiving questions. Ready? Bessie, come on. I need to have a look at this one. Did you have some questions as well?
Yeah.
Okay.
First of all, I'm already blown away by your menu. I was texting my sister, and I was like, you know, we might need to change things up with Jamaican. So we do usually do traditional Jamaican dishes.
No, they want to see your fire ass in the camera because you're going to get a lot of that little
But, I mean, after you've already went through that amazing menu, are those the typical items that you would normally, that most families would choose to cook or feast on for Thanksgiving? So I want to ask you, about turkeys, because you named a lot of amazing turkeys. What about fried turkey?
Hello.
So a few weeks ago, I actually kind of put on Facebook, hey guys, what kind of turkey would you like to eat? I think I listed maybe 10 or 12 of them. Right. And so I just kind of let my Facebook friends tell me what they like to eat. And I think there was a fried turkey on the menu, but the ones that we put on our Thanksgiving menu were the most requested, the most, hey, I want to eat that.
Yeah.
And so for sure, if I get a fried turkey request.
Don't bring it up to you. I'm not able.
Yeah, for sure, we can oblige. But we chose that menu specifically because we kind of threw out some ideas and let the people choose what they'd like to see.
Nice. Speaking of turkey, what size bird should one buy? Let's say for a family of 10.
So I like to say a pound and a half per person.
A pound and a half per person. Okay.
Because you got to take into account, you know, there's going to be bones, there'll be some waste, there'll be some shrinkage once you cook it up.
Okay.
So, you know, if the turkey is your only protein, you know, then a pound and a half is great. You know, most families, though, they either have a turkey, they have a ham. You know, my family, we do duck. We don't really do turkey.
Oh, yeah. But I did eat meat. That was my best.
Duck. So
your mom cooks.
Yeah, I don't cook on Thanksgiving at my house.
Really? Okay.
So what does mommy cook? What does that spread look
so
like?
So mommy cooks, she cooks the duck, she cooks ham, she does collard greens, she does dressing, which I love, and I have not
been
to duplicate. Yeah, she does it with like chicken liver gravy,
chicken
cornbread. Mm. Yeah. It's, y'all, you see that?
Yeah.
I
love
my
dog. Yeah.
I'm gonna get my beverage and I'm gonna get out of here. You know,
we'll get a casserole.
She makes it all the time. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Are y'all hungry yet?
Yeah.
I know I am. I cannot wait. Okay. So, what is the best way to thaw a turkey? Because, of course, most of the time we get a turkey, that shit is like.
Yeah, so the safest way
okay.
to thaw a turkey would be to work in advance. So okay. don't buy your turkey the day before. Buy your turkey like a week out and pull it out 3 days before and let it defrost under refrigeration.
For 3 days?
Yeah, I mean, that's really the safe way to
okay.
defrost anything is under refrigeration, not leaving it out.
Okay.
Because then you risk the chance of foodborne illness and leaving things out at temperatures that are unsafe. So refrigeration. Defrosting under refrigeration is
okay.
the safest way. And depending on the size of your turkey, it could take 3 days to defrost.
Interesting.
Yeah, for sure.
How can I get a beautiful golden brown turkey without drying out the breast meat?
So there are lots of different ways to do that. People always say brining.
Mm-hmm.
If you brine a turkey, your face is brown.
Brining.
I know it's something to do with salts.
Yeah.
Okay.
So brines are salt-based marinades, if you will, but there is no oil. So what truly makes the marinade is oil and vinegar. A brine is.
Sorry, Alexa was actually responding to me.
Fresh herbs like thyme and sage, that kind of stuff. So then you let them soak overnight, and then you pull them out. You let them dry out completely. Let the turkey dry out, and then you cook it while it's dry, and then you'll get that nice crispy skin. But your meat will still be tender.
Did you know all of
this? I watch a lot of Food Network.
Okay, so
I kind of knew it, but I wouldn't be able to articulate the way that she did.
Okay.
Yes.
So do I need to baste a turkey while it's cooking?
Sure, you can baste a turkey. If your turkey is creating juices,
okay.
Then absolutely you want to take those juices and kind of repurpose them and glaze the top of your turkey throughout. But what you don't want to do is be in the oven every 5 minutes moving around the turkey because you'll never get the consistency that you want,
okay.
the texture. Yeah.
How do you stuff turkeys? I've heard of stuffed turkeys.
Yeah, you can stuff them.
Okay.
I personally don't stuff them.
Okay.
I think that you can do so much other stuff. Well, when I do stuff them, I stuff them with aromatics. So
okay.
oranges and herbs
okay.
and stuff like that. Things that are going to permeate throughout the turkey to
mm-hmm.
give it flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Not necessarily stuff like dressing because or dressing
right,
or stuffing.
Right. Okay.
Because we can create that on the side and give you a really cool dish.
Mm-hmm. Nice. How do I know the correct turkey cooking time? Can I trust the couple timer? I said to do that.
I think that most times it's like 20 minutes per pound.
Okay.
And that's
20 minutes per pound. You guys got that?
That's usually the
okay.
average. Yeah, like 20 minutes per pound. So if you have like a 10-pound turkey, 200 minutes. Was that like 2.5-3 hours? Maybe 3 hours or so. 3 hours, 20 minutes. So that's usually the kind of lay of the land, 20 minutes per pound.
Okay, nice.
Can I just ask real quick? First of all, you blew me away. Just smoked Gouda is one of my favorite cheeses of all time. But for the typical mac and cheese, what are some really great cheeses for a macaroni and cheese dish?
Good question. My best friend is greedy as fuck. I love
it.
I love it.
Y'all don't even know how this cleanse is killing me. But
so I like switching it up. Smoked Gouda is obviously a really great one, but I love jack cheeses, like pepper
mm-hmm.
jack, Monterey jack.
Mm-hmm.
Those kinds of cheeses are really cool. Even if you use stuff like Parmesan, if you use a good Parmesan or a good Asiago cheese,
mm-hmm.
those are great.
you know, the standard cheddar cheeses. If you kind of mix up the sharp cheddars with the mild cheddars, mm-hmm. those are always good. You're going to get a different texture, a different flavor, depending on what you do. I think where people kind of mistake is when they start doing all of those cheeses, right? Mm. I feel like you could get three different mac and cheeses based on, you know, with flavor and texture. If you kind of keep them separate, if you kind of get to know your cheeses.
That's a different perspective.
Yeah, I'm like, yeah, I think people say, oh my gosh, I got like a 12 cheese mac.
Yeah.
What does your mac taste like? Like, what is that? You know, like, keep it, you know, keep it simple, keep it sexy, and then it'll be really, really good.
Are we good over here? Because I don't want to be the talking.
I should have a question.
We have a question in the back. Okay, hold on. Let me go to one of our influencers. We have a question. My fellow bald-headed sister. All right, we got it.
What's a good Asiago or Parmesan? What type?
So I love just a nice shaved parm. If you get a good, and here's the other thing: buy your cheeses in blocks. If you get the blocks and either shave or grate them yourself, you get such a better product than buying them already shredded. First of all, you're going to get more money, more bang for your buck as far as money. And then you just get a better quality because the stuff that they sell already shredded, they're banking on you not being able to recognize that it's not a good quality. So if you go into a deli, you know, whether it's Publix or Penn Dutch or whatever, or even into those specialty markets, if you go into one and get a good block, you'll be good to go.
Any particular brand?
Yeah.
No. But the block is the best.
Yeah, blocks are the best. I find to be, for sure. Thank you.
Mm-hmm. What would you say is one of the biggest myths that is being pushed out by whomever when it comes to cooking? Whether it be a particular type of ingredient, a brand, like for example, my girlfriend, when she goes, there's a certain man. What mayonnaise you can buy? What brand? Hellman's. If it's not Hellman's, it's like it's not going to be it.
Or
yeah.
Cheese is actually cheese. Like. So
correct.
The S or crap.
Yeah. So not what are some
Sargento.
So I mean, is there any validity to that?
Well, having worked in grocery, and particularly working for a company that specializes in providing off brands, I know that off brands are often made by the same companies that make those brands that you love.
Facts.
So and it's just, you know, you're paying for the brand, you're paying for the name on it. So, you know, with that, I would just say, just kind of work with what you like, and be adventurous in the store when you grocery shop and pick out certain things. And there are certain things where I would go through that store because I worked there and I buy stuff. I'd be like, hey, this is the same. And then I buy some else and be like, that ain't the same. I don't want that, you know, you get what I mean? And so, you know, not being, so caught up on the brand.
Okay.
And really, if you're a foodie, be a foodie. And try it and taste it and figure out what works for you.
All right. So let's say someone is watching this show and they're like, you know what? I want to try this foodie life, but I don't know where to start. Okay. So let's say you wanted to introduce somebody into that foodie world. Mm-hmm. What is one of the first maybe places or things that you would suggest? For example, one of the things that I know that I really like doing are those foodie tours. Like the Miami foodie tour, the South Beach food tour. What would be the best introduction into really starting to sample different foods?
That's a great one, doing those tours. And then also when we get into what we call in the industry now season, like right now from like October to February, go on event sites,
okay.
Things like foodie sites or Eventbrite or all kinds of different places, even Ticketmaster, and look for foodie events. Lots of people, including myself, we throw pop-up dinner parties and stuff like that. So if there's a chef or even just a foodie group, meetup.com does tons of really cool stuff.
Really?
So like if you go around and just hang out with other foodies, you will eat new stuff. And it doesn't necessarily mean it has to be expensive. You don't necessarily have to spend a whole lot of money, but you absolutely will get exposed to things that you wouldn't typically eat. So just look for foodie groups. Look for pop-up dinner parties. Just recently, I went to a wine pairing that I thought was very inexpensive for what I got. I got to drink like 6 or 7 different wines, and I had 5 or 6 different courses for like $50. And I was,
wow.
You get what I mean? I was full. I was lit when I was done.
Hello.
but the food was great at a restaurant that I probably would not have gone to. So just look out for stuff like that. You know, look out for specials on. You know, I don't want to promote too many different things, but if you go to those different websites that have specials, then look for those types of things.
Yeah. Sure. I would say that my introduction into Peruvian food was from one of those tours.
Yeah.
Yes, I definitely agree with that. Okay, yeah. So we talked about Thanksgiving. We know Christmas is coming up, right? So the holiday after that is Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
And when I was doing some research on you, I saw that you actually do some really sexy. Girl, don't be breaking the people's shit now.
That's my stuff. I brought it.
Don't break it.
But
now.
I don't
want to
break it. I don't want to break it.
We got baby. We got Dyson. Shout out to Dyson, by the way. Expensive as hell, but those vacuums are about life, okay? They will vacuum up everything that you need. But anyway, so Valentine's Day is coming up, and I did some research on you. We good? Get over there?
Yeah.
All right. Valentine's Day is coming up. I did some research on you, and you actually put together, like, romantic. Talk about that. Just walk me through that. What is it?
So, which one? So, we got two things. Last
Day-day.
Year.
It's yeah. called Day-day?
Yeah, last year.
That's real sexy, because a lot of people, especially guys, where my camera? Guys, they get so frustrated and so nervous and overwhelmed with what to do. And I think that sometimes, you know, the material gifts are nice, but I think that what you offer and what I saw that you do, I was absolutely inspired by it. And I think that more people should know that it's not only available, but it's affordable. So talk a little bit about Bay Day. Walk us through what the experience is like and, of course, how we can get more.
So Bay Day was a lot like how we came to the conclusion for doing the Thanksgiving dinners. Again, there's only so many people who I can service on Valentine's Day, right? If I come to a private dinner for you and your partner, I can do you, and maybe I can do it one other brunch that day. But so we created Bay Day, and we sold 50 seats for couples and singles to come out and
wait. Hold on, singles. So y'all just greedy. Y'all was just being greedy, okay?
The singles need love too, you know.
Bay Day for real.
I think we did some matchmaking there. You know, okay. We did a little matchmaking.
They were trying to holler at you. Maybe that's what that was.
I was cooking.
All right, so we got Bay Day.
Yeah, so we did Bay Day. We sold 50 seats. It was a 5-course dinner, wine, cocktails, and then 5 courses of a really cool meal. And so it was great. People got to eat things that they would never eat. We did a really great, the menu in itself was kind of infused with aphrodisiacs, edible aphrodisiacs. So we did.
Intentionally.
Of course.
You set it up.
I mean, it was we were trying to go for sex. We were going for culinary. We were going for sexy, you know? So we did an oyster cod chowder.
Can I ask you a question?
Sure.
Now, they said the oysters is aphrodisiac. Is it an aphrodisiac for men and women or just men?
I like oysters. I'm not a doctor. I don't know. I know that they're an aphrodisiac. I have not gotten specifics on that.
Could you kill him?
Yes.
I'm gonna behave because you know we got mama. What about what is it? Kunk? Is kunk aphrodisiac for male and woman?
I've not heard kunk being.
Or is it a little piston? Is what they call it. The piston if you want to get pregnant. Is that what it is?
I don't know about that.
You don't know about that. How are we doing in the kitchen?
We're almost there.
What time is looking like?
Yeah, we probably got about 2 or 3 more minutes.
2 or 3 minutes. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to get all of our influencers sitting down and ready to eat. Did you want to start maybe with the drink?
Oh, sure.
All right, so what drink is it? It's in here.
Yeah.
So we got the that. Mm-hmm. That right there.
The that.
Yeah, I can't fill my fridge because that's one thing I did. Yeah. Right? Okay. Don't talk about my fridge. All right. So what is this? You want a can opener? Yes, absolutely. I'm gonna give you the custom made a fridge or party can opener.
Yes.
Where can we at? Right there. Any fancy at all?
Yeah.
$29.99.
I'm not much of a beer drinker, but when I do, I like a hard cider.
Okay.
And you know, mimosas are
too. Wait, how do you know they're all gonna have one beer to the head? Y'all ready to drink?
It's only 6. Let me do
this. Okay, you guys, you ain't new to this. You true to this. And my bad. I apologize. I was wrong. She was right. Who am I? She's kitchen killer in the kitchen.
So. Okay. You know, traditionally for brunch, we do mimosas and stuff like that, right? Okay. So it's like a champagne and orange juice. or even Bellinis. But I like to switch it up and do angry salsa. So this is like a hard cider.
Yeah.
Angry orchard, mix it with orange juice. So it's an angry salsa instead of a mimosa.
Nice. I've never had this before.
Yes.
So I'm actually excited. And
I think I got an extra glass for you.
Hey. Thank you. My friends today and like chef. So let me get some money. I'm gonna have to get my chef.
That's cool.
You ready for that?
You have to outbid some couple.
Oh. Don't do me. You know what? Don't do me. I can't get a 20% though.
Is that my thing? Okay. Should I go and serve it?
Yeah, yeah. But do you mind? I mean, are you better than that? What are we doing? I don't know. How does this work? Okay, well, I'm going to have it. So this is my first time. So it is the Angry Orchard and OJ. So that's what you guys are going to be served. I know Upgrade Your Party had you lit. You okay? Because your eyes are looking. People are going to die right now. You're right. I'll make it up. Is that Mary Kay though? Because your face is beat to God. What is that?
Is that Mary Kay? No, Maybelline.
Okay. All right. So we got Mary J. Blige. We got, okay. So we're going to go ahead and take them. I'm going to have them actually all toast together. And Kitchen Killer, we're going to actually toast to you. We're going to toast to you. We're going to congratulate you on the amazing job that you're doing.
Thank you much.
We're going to congratulate you on continuing to thrive in your business. Much success. I want to thank you. This is a big deal. Girl, listen.
I'm trying to support them. Y'all got me over here doing
this. I want to thank you so much for taking the time out of you are definitely a big deal. As well as all of my guests here today, and for you to take the time out of your busy schedule to come here and to do this and to demonstrate what it is that you do, to share the things that we that you've shared. Like I appreciate you. I really do. Can y'all help me? Because I got some glass. Can y'all help me clap it up for Miss Kitchen? We all have our glasses. Are you gonna drink with us? All right. So we are going to, because 2019 is just around the corner.
It is.
So we're going to drink to much success for 2018 and even more success for 2019. Let's cheers to Kitchen Killer, guys. Cheers. Yay. Yay. All right. Let's take it. We know we got PR on site, child. We got it. You got it? We good? Only because the kneecaps are sexy. That's the only reason. Let's taste it.
Oh, wait.
I like this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, baby, I wonder if we could order this instead of when we go into the mimosas. We could actually order. Isn't it good?
A lot of restaurants don't carry it.
A lot of they don't carry it.
Yeah, a lot of them don't.
Yeah, that's really good.
But here, it is good.
I like that.
So I'm gonna come to the table. You guys see those cast iron plates in front of you? I'm gonna sit hot cast irons on top of those.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's four of them. So between the six of you, you can share.
Let me get my list. Y'all burn.
We
have pescatarians over here with the purple. We got Coco and myself.
Are you gonna position yourself like Coco so you can share?
I could do that. Let me go ahead. All right, let me go ahead. So I'm gonna position myself. It's live, y'all. Fuck you, it's live.
Okay.
Can I have my drink? God damn it, Nancy.
It's holding it for you.
Shit, get your own. You should kill a Nancy Walker, damn it. All right, so I'm actually going to hang out over here. I really wanted them to get the opportunity because, of course, you know, I'm going to have my own spirit later. But I'm going to position myself over here, get my little chair. And I actually, for those of you that are here, I got some little red plates in the so you guys can actually get a chance to taste a little bit as well. Look at you being such a gentleman. What's your fine chocolate yourself? Trust her from Jumanji. You gotta get it. All right. I'm excited, guys. This is like some really classy shit.
Coming in hot, okay?
All right.
We got the pictures. I got the cinnamon. We have any questions for my dad? What we got going on? Debbie says she puts the pepper jack cheese in her grits today, and she gave it a great flavor. Go on, Debbie. Crystal Randall said, get it.
That's
hello.
I'm excited.
Okay. Can y'all zoom in? Y'all zoom in and get this? The presentation, the smell, first of all, is amazing. It's like an orgasm in my mouth. I just wanted to say that word. I mean, when you say that word all night, orgasm in my mouth. Okay. So, do we have permission to dine? How do we do this? It's my first time doing a lot of
things. I put some sharing spoons in the middle, so you guys can grab those to put onto your plate.
Okay. So, the ones that eat. They can taste our shrimp one as well as what you're saying.
Yeah, they're not too sure.
All right, let's go ahead. Let's get this. Let's get a first little bite.
Those cast irons are hot, though.
Cast irons are hot.
We're
going to cast them. So we got to have a little bite.
Yeah, leave it where it is.
And then we're going to kind of get some feedback on how it's tasting. And I'm not going to keep my audience the entire time that we're dining. But I wanted you guys to at least get an opportunity to see if the shit tastes good or not. So, gentlemen.
I'm with the room.
I get it.
I get it.
All right, so we're all going to take the first. Mary J. Blige, you interested?
No.
Okay. All right. So we're all going to take the first bite together on the count of three. You ready? D, you ready?
Ready.
You ready, Wiggly? All right. One, two, three.
It's round turkey.
That's round turkey. Yeah. Did you infuse the shrimp with some extra shit? Because it don't taste like shrimp. It tastes like shrimp a la shrimp to the shrimp a la shrimp.
I use those fresh herbs, salt, and pepper.
Okay, so what am I tasting in the shrimp? And I'll let you guys talk about that turkey too.
What are you tasting? So the herbs I used were rosemary, thyme, and sage. Salt, pepper, real simple, and then we'll maple syrup also to sweeten it up.
And if I understand correctly, you cooked it on the stove top first.
Right, and then finished it in the oven.
Finish in the oven. I'm fine. All right, I'm sorry. I'm going to be a good hostess and go around talking to you. You work for twerk?
I do not. I'm sorry. FPL does not.
All right, so I know your mouth is cold, but please tell me. What's going on in your mouth right now?
And the time it balances out. The turkey is good. I like the little bit of sweetness. And it has a little more dimension to it. So it all blends together very well.
Yes. So thumbs up from you?
Yes,
very much
so.
Yeah. Leave me alone. Let me finish eating.
Suzette, darling.
I think the blend of flavor is amazing.
Pairing the sweet potato with the ground turkey is just incredible. Mm-hmm. It just pops. It's so complimentary. I love that she toppled with the egg. I would love to try it again with a softer milk. I love the soft milk. But all of it together is just incredible. You can't look at it and know where you have yet.
No.
So you taste it. Just
great observation. I agree. Thank you so much for sharing. You and your husband okay? Y'all okay? They really mad, but it was a time right there. Mary J. Blige, wait, hold up. Why your plate empty on Mary J. Blige? Mary J. That was clearly you enjoyed it. Let's talk about it.
Absolutely, yeah. I have to piggyback what they said. It seems to be a perfect blend of all the ingredients. It's not too much of one thing, and I didn't know what to expect, but it is definitely something that I would love to like have on a normal basis.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, clearly based on your plate, that's empty. Okay, so
you know I'm a little nervous talking to you.
It's kind of what you do. So let's talk about it.
Okay. I really like it. I mean, usually ground turkey is like so bland.
I agree.
But she added like just the right amount of herb and everything to it to really give it a nice kick. And it's sweet, but like not too sweet.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a really nice combination.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, absolutely. I really like it.
Well, I appreciate that. And do you think that the cream that she made her with it well?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, it was good. Yeah. I enjoyed that as well. That was really good. You guys gotta try the shrimp one too if you want. It was really good. That shrimp, it literally tastes like it was infused with some other stuff, like it wasn't just shrimp. And I definitely, you know, Carol, I agree with you with having the fresh herbs. It makes such a difference.
Yeah, right?
Oh my God, it makes such a difference.
Hey, boo.
Hi. Chofonzo. Okay, so what did you think?
I loved it. I definitely think the fresh herbs made a big difference. I like that there's a little bit of sweetness, but it's not overpowering. You get like a total combination. It's really smooth combination. It really blends really well. So I'm excited about that.
Yeah.
I'm excited to try the shrimp one too.
Pause. Okay.
I thought I was going to speak that.
Yeah. You're good. You got the shoe on the hell out of the shorts. You can have my shrimp.
Coco, do you love me? Are you running?
Girl, bitch, wait, hold up, bitch. When I left, there was a lot more food on that plate. You want to
make most of it.
Oh, right. You're right. So we had the, because we're vegetarians, we had the, am I pretty out?
I'm good.
Okay. So we had the shrimp one. How was it?
That was good. I'm not a huge fan of, I really thought the eggs were going to be runny. So I was a little fearful because I hate runny eggs, but they were perfect. As far as the herbs, like I love it, and I'm not a huge sage lover at all, especially in school. We're always cooking with sage, and I cannot stand it. The smell on the face, but
so Kiara, you over here popping cherries, having people like things that they never thought that they would like. So, guys, overall, on the count of three, thumbs up or thumbs down. 1, 2, 3, thumbs up.
Thumbs up.
Guys, thank you so much for joining us for our first live cooking show on My Life, Raw, Real, and All the Way Live. Let me go ahead and welcome to my chef because I cannot end my show, but I have a chef, Kiara, next to me. My apron on. You like it?
I do.
This is awesome. Did you have a good time?
I did. It was fun. Absolutely. Yeah.
You share a lot of things with us. I learned a lot of things about you. I'm so excited about what's to happen. I wish you all the best in 2019.
I think about
TV Takeover and what, where we are, what we're doing, and the fact that someone such as yourself is on the show. This is monumental for us, and I want you to know that we will cherish this show and this episode forever. And thank you so much.
You guys popped my TV cherry, so
we popped each other pretty sure. Guys, thank you so much for tuning in to the TV Takeover.
Okay,
I'll make us some more. You make us some more TV Takeover, My Life, Raw, Real, All the Way Live. Guys, we are on YouTube Live today. We are on Facebook Live, and we are on Instagram Live, and some other shit. I think I got 1, 2, 3, I kind of like 7 cameras in here. Thank you so much. Thank you for tuning in. This has been absolutely amazing. Make sure that you guys are liking our page, you're following us. Make sure that you tap into all of these amazing, let's look at my guests real quick.
Make sure you tap into all of my amazing guests as well. We have a wealth of knowledge at this table, Suzette. Again, if you guys are interested in getting your social media on and popping, make sure that you hit her up. Her information will be coming on the timeline as well. But DJ, go ahead. Let's get some kitchen camera music so we can get this party ended and enjoy the rest of our meal. Appreciate you. This is awesome. Let's clap it up, y'all. Hey! Oh, look at the camera! And it's so crap, y'all! And it's so stepping!